Hello friends, welcome back to our session. So in today's session we'll discuss about a few elements of form stack. So coming to this form stack, so we are supposed to listen these type of forms in our regular life, like registration forms, right? Registration forms or a login forms. Okay, login forms. So while filling up the any type of application, so we are supposed to fill these type of registration forms. So in that we'll generally observe these type of symbols. Okay, if it is an online application, so these type of symbols will be considered, and circles and some square boxes and some large rectangles. Okay, and there might be some drop downs. Okay, some drop downs and some buttons, right? So these are normally called as text box. This is called a text box. Okay, this type of symbols we call it as a text box, and this type of symbols we call it as a radio buttons. Radio buttons. Okay, radio buttons. And this type of symbols we call it as a checkboxes. Checkbox. Okay, and this is called as a text area. Text area. And this is selection. Select. Okay, select tab. Select tab. Okay, and this one is nothing but a button. This one is a button. Okay, so all these comes under forms tag. Okay, so in the forms tag we are supposed to learn the text boxes, similarly the radio buttons, similarly the check boxes, the text area, selection statements, selection tags, buttons, and etc. Right? So in today's session we'll cover the first four concepts, and in the further sessions we'll cover the remaining concepts. Right? First we'll check with these four categories. So what are the text boxes, when we have to use these text boxes, and the radio buttons, text area, and all these things. First I will give you the explanation, and then I will implement in the computer. Right? So we'll create a text box, radio buttons, check boxes, as well as the text areas in the system. Right? Coming to the text boxes, so there are two types of text boxes. So whatever it may be, the text box can be created with the help of input tag. So we have to write it as input type. Input type. Okay, so these are the inputs given by the client or given by the user. Okay, so input type is equal to, so this type may be text box, radio, or a checkbox. So if you are giving type as a text, then a text box will be created. A text box will be created. And there is a one more attribute called a name. So we can give a name so that that can be used in a scripting. That means the cascading style sheets, when you are applying the CSS, then those names will be used. So we can give any name. Okay. F name. Let us create F name. F name means a first name, right? So a name, and then value. So value means the default value which is displayed on the screen. The default value. So if this value is some enter name, so this will be displayed on the screen, right? So and another one is size. So we can give the size of the text. Okay, here we can give the size of the text, and a max size. So how much it should be accepted, how much length it should be accepted, that should be given in the max size. So for example 20, so close the input, right? So input type is equal to text, automatically a text box will be created. So then by applying all these attributes, some sort of formatting will be done on this text box. So like name is equal to fname, that can be used in a CSS. Value is equal to enter name, so by default that will be displayed here, that will be displayed here, right? So by default value will be displayed. So all these are optionals. Okay, all these are optionals. Simply you can close the input here itself, you can close the input here itself. But so by applying all these things we can get it. So maximum 20 means 20 characters can be inserted in this text box. So this is a normal text box, the syntax for the normal text box. So if you want to go with the hidden text, if you want to display the hidden text, okay, so that means we are supposed to see two different types of text boxes in the login page. That is, one is a username, so that can be visible to all the users, and the second text box is the password related text box, so that whatever the content entered by the user will not be visible to all the users, right? Some other symbols will be occupied in the place of characters, so that so no one can view the know the actual characters, right? So such type of text boxes will be created in a different way. So like input type is equal to, instead of going with the text, go with the password, go with the password, and rest of the thing is same, and the rest of the thing is same. So just you can close this one, so that we'll get one more text box, and whatever the thing you are typing here automatically will get the text in terms of stars, so that cannot be visible to all. That cannot be visible to all. So in order to give this one, the normal text must be displayed, and if you, in order to get this password, you have to give the type is equal to password, right? So this is all about our text boxes, right? I will show you everything in the system, right? Don't worry. The next one is the radio buttons. Coming to the radio button. So coming to the radio button, so the representation of radio button is circle. Okay, so most probably coming to the gender. Okay, if you want to give the gender, the option for the gender, we are supposed to give this radio buttons. So you can observe here a circle, and in after that circle you'll get male, and again circle will get some female. So the user have to select either male or a female, but not both. Okay, so that is a feature of the radio button. So only one selection can be done. It cannot be done the multiple selections. Okay, if you select this male, automatically this will be disabled. And if you select this female, automatically this male will be disabled. So only one button will be selected. So this type of things, we call it as a radio buttons. Okay, so in order to create that one, again the same syntax. Go to the input type is equal to, go with the radio. So instead of giving the text, give the radio. Okay, and follow the name. So whatever the things we are giving the radio buttons, you just group all the things with the same name, so that it is possible to select only one selection, right? So if you are not giving any, if you are not grouping all these things with the same name, then we can select the multiple elements, okay, multiple statements. So name is equal to some gender, okay, name is equal to some gender, and there is a one more function called checked. So if you use this checked in particular radio button, that will be by default, that will be selected. Okay, so in which text we are writing this, in which radio button we are writing this one, so that radio button will be by defaultly, it will be selected. See, I will tell you. So again, one more text box, radio button I am creating. Some type is equal to some radio, okay, and group the name. So if you are failed to group the name under same category, so automatically it will be having the multiple selections, it will enable the multiple selections. See, name is equal to gender, So if you write the same code, automatically this will be the by default. If you execute the page, this mail will be selected by default because we are using this checked property. And if you are not using this checked property here, we will get the radio buttons, none will be selected. No, not even a single statement will be selected, right? And if you pass this checked here, if you use the property checked here, so the checked is here, right? So you have to write the statement, right? Female and male. Okay, so automatically what we'll get? So under female we are writing the checked. So this will be selected here. This will be selected here. Right, so this is how we can use the radio buttons. So radio buttons means selecting only one selection, so it will be accepting only one selection. And coming to the next one, so I will execute all these things, don't worry. The next one is checkbox. So checkbox means the multiple selections. So if you want to select multiple items, then we'll go with this checkbox. Best example for this checkbox is hobbies. So while entering your hobbies, so one person can have a multiple hobbies, right? So in such cases we need to select multiple hobbies, so there must be a multiple selections. So in such a way, so this will be like a square. Okay, square singing, similarly square playing, similarly square reading, okay, and a square painting. Like this you can have a lot of hobbies. So one person can have a multiple selections, right? So one person can have a multiple hobbies like singing, playing, or playing and reading, or reading and painting, like this. So in such cases we have to go with the checkboxes. See, for checkbox go with the same syntax. Input type is equal to checkbox. Input type is equal to checkbox. Okay, and also we can give the name and value. It's an optional thing. So we can give the name, group the name, okay, group the name, hobbies, and also you can give the value or you can skip, no problem. It's an optional argument. And this is also here also, there is an option called checked. Okay, there is an option called checked. So if it is checked, automatically the statement will be selected. Or you need not go with this one because this is a multiple selection. So we need not go with this checked options, checked attribute. So here you can observe, so singing. Okay, and again go with the same thing. Input type is equal to checkbox. Some name is equal to some hobbies. Group everything in under single name. Okay, group everything in a single name. And here you can write a playing. Similarly, reading, painting. Okay, so this is a simple code to create a checkbox. So input type is equal to checkbox. If input type is equal to text, a text box will be created. If input type is equal to password, a password text box will be created. If input type is equal to radio, radio buttons will be created. If input type is equal to checkbox, all these checkbox will be created. Right, so this is how we can create the checkboxes. And the last one, we'll go with this one and we'll see the execution part in the system. So the next one is a text area. Text area. So this text area is the best example for giving the address, taking the address from the user. Right, so in order to take the address from the user, we are supposed to write multiple lines. Right, so far coming to the text box, it is a single line input. Okay, it will take the single line input. But if you want to take a multiple line input, we have to go with the text area. So there is a separate tag called text area. Okay, and here I am saying that we can give the input in a multiple lines. Multiple lines means rows and columns. So here there are two attributes called rows. Rows is equal to some five rows, okay, and calls means column. Okay, calls means column is equal to some 20 columns. So it will create a text area. It will create a text area with the five rows and 20 columns. Okay, with the 20 columns, so total 20 columns. So this will be created. So this is called a text area. So it will be having some five rows and 20 columns, 5 rows and 20 columns. So this type of box will be created, and after the completion of this one, just we have to close the text area. We have to close the text area, right? So this is the starting tag, ending tag, opening tag, closing tag, right? So text area, rows and columns are the two attributes for this text area, and we have to close the text area. So this is all about our few form elements like text box, radio, checkbox and text area. So in the coming sessions we'll see a few more elements, and then we'll create one simple registration form. I will show you how to prepare or how to create a simple registration form, right? So in the next session we'll going to see the buttons and the selection tags. So before going to the next session, just we'll check the implementation part of all these things. We'll create the text boxes, we'll create the radio buttons, we'll create the checkbox, and we'll create the text area. So let us move on to the computer.
Yeah, hello friends. So just now we have seen the theoretical part of all the form elements like text box, radio button, checkbox and text area. So now we will implement the form elements. So just open the notepad and write down the HTML tags. Okay, in between the HTML tag we have to write the forms, and inside the HTML also we have to write all these things in the body, right? So give the body. So inside the body tag we have to write the forms, right? So I'm creating the form, so I'm opening the form tag, and see here I have to implement the text box. First we will go with the text box. In the text box we have seen two different types. One is for a normal text box and another one is for using the password, right? Typing the password. So first normal text box will give, so give the name for the text box. So I will give some first name or username. Okay, you can take the username as a this one, right? So username. And for implementing the text box we have to go with the input type. Okay, input type. Input type is equal to, if it is a text box we have to type here text. Okay, give the name, because the name will be used in scripting itself, right? So while we are discussing about the JavaScript, so then the name will be used. So give some name here. Okay, just give username. Okay, then a value. So here there is a one more attribute called value, so which gives the default value. So username, right? And also we can give the maximum length. There is a one more parameter or this attribute called maximum length. So how much length it should be restricted, right? So maximum length is equal to some 7. Okay, maximum length is equal to 7. All right, so I'm closing this one. Just save this one with a name .html. So I will go with the form.html, and you can observe. So in the desktop you will find this form.html. So whenever you double click this form.html, automatically this text box will be appeared. So let us check this one. See, you got it. Username colon. So this is the text box. So where we can write the text. Okay. So here, if you observe, we have given some value is equal to username. So by default, the text will be displayed in the text box. If I am not giving anything in the value, okay, if I am not giving anything in the value attribute, so we'll not get anything here. Okay, so maximum length is equal to 7. So see, you can observe. So I am typing, but it was stopped at the number 7. So it will accept only the 7 characters. It will accept only the 7 characters. So we can restrict this one. We can restrict the number of characters or the size of the text we are displaying or we are typing in the text box, right? For that we have to go with the max length, the attribute called max length. Okay, and also we can go with the size attribute. So in order to display this one, so size is equal to from 20. So you can observe here, if you press this one, so the size will be the 20 and the maximum length it will be 7. Okay, so like this we can implement this text box. And there is a another way of using this text box, that is using for typing the passwords. So see, Here, for getting the password type of text box, we have to go with the input type is equal to, instead of giving the text, we have to go with the password. Password, and same attributes we can that can be repeated. So the name attribute can be used for the JavaScripting. Okay, and value also by default value, and a maximum length on all these things are same. So we'll check whether it was implemented or not. So I'm just refreshing it. So you got it, username and a password. So if you print here username, if you type here the username, so it will be displayed. Okay, the text will be displayed. I will give the maximum as a 20. Okay, so that we can type the required text. See, I have executed, and in order to give the username, I can give the username, right? And coming to the password, when I type the password, you can observe that the data is not visible here. Okay, the data is not visible. So it was directly encrypted in by using some symbol called dot. So whenever you are typing the data, it will not be displayed. So this happens only when you give the type as password. This is another way of creating a text box. So even though this is a text box, okay, this is also a text box, but the data will be hidden. The data will be in hidden because the password should not be revealed to the public, right? So in order to create a forms, you can use the normal text box for the usernames and all these things. And coming to the passwords, you can create a text box with a password, type password, right? So this is all about our text box. And coming to the radio buttons. See, so we, in the previous sessions, we have seen the headers, different types of headers. So I have taken this header and I'm giving some heading as radio buttons. Okay, so we know that radio buttons means only single selection. Okay, there should not be a multiple selection, right? So if you are studying in general, the radio buttons, the best example for the radio buttons is a gender, right? So we can go with the gender. So just give the thing, so gender. Okay, so I will tell you H2 and close the heading, and coming to the gender, give the male colon. So in order to create the radio button, as we have discussed, the input type is equal to radio. Input type is equal to radio. Okay, it will directly normally creates the radio button. Okay, see, let us check. Input type is equal to radio. So just we are creating the radio buttons. Okay, I will show you. See, if you observe here, you can get it. See, gender, male, female. So if you give the tag br, the break line, break row, it will be displayed in the second column. Okay, so you can observe here. See, the male and female. So if you select this one, so one should be selected. If the multiple selections should not be done in the radio buttons, but here you can observe. So if you press on the male, it will be selected, and if you press on a female, it will be selected. So this is the wrong thing, right? So we are not supposed to select the two radio buttons at a time. So at a time only one should be selected. Multiple selection should not be done. For this purpose, we have to group these things by giving a same name. Okay, so there is an attribute called name. So name is equal to gender. So give the same name for the name. That means group these two radio buttons under the same name, right? So you can observe here. Now see, if I select the male, it will be selected. If I select the female, automatically the male will be deselected, right? So If you fail to group this name, particularly in these radio buttons, so automatically the multiple selections will be accepted, which is not correct in the radio buttons. Okay, so radio buttons means selecting only one criteria. Okay, and if you want to be select by default, There is a one more attribute called checked. Checked, okay. Checked is equal to give the result as checked. Okay. So you can observe here. So if you refresh, automatically I have given this checked attribute. Okay, checked attribute is equal to checked for the mail option. So if you refresh this one, by default the mail is selected. By default the mail will be selected. Okay, and if you use this checked in the female, you can observe, if you refresh, by default the female will be selected. Okay, so in order to get by default one radio button to be selected, you have to go with the attribute called check, right? So this is about the radio buttons. Hope you got it. This you got the radio buttons, you understood the radio buttons, right? So we'll go with the check boxes. The next one is a check boxes. Checkbox. Okay. So coming to the checkbox. See, hobbies. So in order to give the hobbies, you can go with the checkboxes. That means it will accept the multiple selections. It will accept the multiple selections, right? So write down the hobbies. So first write down the create the checkbox. So in order to create the checkbox, the same syntax, input type is equal to here. So you have to go with checkbox. Okay, instead of giving the text radio, we have to give the checkbox. That's it. And similarly, we can give the name and a value. You can give the name and value that can be used in JavaScripting, right? So here hobbies, I am writing here some playing. Okay, playing. So I'm giving BR so that it will break the row and it will display in the second line. Okay, so input type is equal to checkbox reading. Okay, reading, and input type is equal to checkbox painting. Okay, so these are the select. So one person can have a multiple hobbies, so we can select a multiple elements, right? Here multiple hobbies. So that's why we are going to use this checkboxes. Type is equal to checkbox singing. Okay, so let's just we'll stop here. So just save this one and you can execute this one. We'll get the hobbies, right? You can observe the checkbox will be in a rectangular shape and radio button will be in a circular shape. So if it is in a circular shape, so only one selection can be done. If it is in a circular, I mean square box, multiple selections can be done. So you can apply, see, my hobbies are playing, reading, singing. Okay, so multiple selections can be done, but here we can't do the multiple selections. You can observe, any one can be selected. If you select the another, automatically the previous one will be deselected. Okay, so this is how we can use the checkboxes. All right, so I will also give here text box. Okay, text box. So these are the headers, right? So already we have studied these headers. Yeah. So I will give some BR so that it will be displayed in the next line. See, you can observe here. Okay. So we can give another BR so that it will be not overlapping. Now, it's good. So text box. It's a login page, radio buttons, the example is a gender, and a checkbox, the example will be the hobbies. And yeah, now we'll go with the another another element, that is a text area. Okay, so text area, that means, so in order to view the text in a multiple lines, we have to go with this text area. So for example, for this one, so if you want to type the address, okay, address of any person, so we can get this, address text area. So for that, there is a tag called text area. So use the text area. And here we have to give the rows and columns. Okay, so rows, because we are supposed to give the multiple lines, so rows is equal to some 5 I will give, and columns is equal to some 15, right? So if I give this one, we'll get the text area. So you can observe here, see, this is the text area. Okay, so we have to close the text area tag, right? Text area, otherwise everything will be printed in that one. Okay, see, you can observe here. So if you give the address, it is text area, and if you give some 50, see, sorry, 50, we'll get the text area. So according to the given rows and columns, the text area will be created. Okay, so this is how we can create the text areas also. So in this session we have seen the text box. In the text box we have seen the normal text and the password, the hidden text. Okay, and also we have seen about the radio buttons, how to create the radio buttons and how to get the default selected radio button, and the checkboxes. Okay, checkboxes, and then the text area. Right, so we'll stop the session. Hope you understood this session, and in the next session we'll go with the some more form elements like select box, file upload, and buttons. Right, so hope you understood this one. If you really understood my sessions, like my session, share my session with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. So thanks for watching. Thank you.